कोरोना वायरस वैक्सीन कब तक आएगी? तैयार होने के बाद इसे भारत आने में कितना समय लगेगा? देश में इसकी कीमत कितनी होगी? ये कितनी सुरक्षित होगी? पहले किसे मिलेगी और क्या ये बुजुर्गों और बच्चों के लिए सुरक्षित होगी? इन सभी सवालों से अब धीरे धीरे पर्दा हटने लगा है। ब्रिटेन के एस्ट्राजेनिका ने सोमवार को कहा कि नोवेल कोरोना वायरस के लिए इसका टीका तकरीबन 90% प्रभावी होगा। बिना किसी साइड इफेक्ट के ये कोविड-19 महामारी को रोकने के लिए दुनिया को एक और महत्वपूर्ण उपकरण देने जैसा है। वैक्सीन के दोनों डोज देने पर संयुक्त विश्लेषण के परिणाम स्वरूप औसतन 70% प्रभावकारिता यानी इफेक्टिवनेस प्राप्त की गई। वहीं सीरम इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंडिया दुनिया में टीके की मात्रा का सबसे बड़ा निर्माता है, जिसे वैश्विक आपूर्ति के लिए कोविड-19 वैक्सीन की 1 अरब से ज्यादा खुराक का उत्पादन करने के लिए एस्ट्राजेनिका, गेट्स फाउंडेशन और गेवी वैक्सीन गठबंधन के साथ भागीदारी की है। ऑक्सफोर्ड के साथ मिलकर वैक्सीन बनाने वाली भारतीय कंपनी सीरम इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंडिया के CEO आधार पूनावाला ने एक बयान में कहा, मुझे ये सुनकर खुशी हुई कि कोविशील्ड एक सस्ती और रखरखाव में आसान और ये जल्द ही व्यापक रूप से उपलब्ध होने वाली कोविड-19 वैक्सीन है। पहली खुराक में ये 90% तक सुरक्षा प्रदान करती है, वहीं इसकी बाकी खुराकों में 62% की सुरक्षा प्रदान करेगी। इसी पर NDTV से बात करते हुए पूनावाला ने कहा,
Whether a vaccine is 60 or 70%, 90%, at this stage where only a few thousand people in these phase 3 trials, you know, have shown this kind of efficacy result, I would not want to, you know, label the vaccine to be at that level at this stage because even though, yes, we are showing 90% efficacy with a half dose and then followed by a full dose, which sounds a bit peculiar that why is that giving you a much better result? That is how it is, and as the days go on, we'll probably get an explanation for that. So indeed, that's good news. But what I mean to say is that unless hundreds of millions of people get the vaccine all over the world in different regions, and you see the disease burden in that region actually going down, like we've seen for pneumonia vaccines, measles vaccines, pentavalent vaccines, etc., you can't really say a vaccine is effective up to a certain level until you are able to see that data. And of course, that will come about in the next 1 or 2 years. But initially, having said that, there's a lot of excitement, whether it's Moderna's vaccine, Pfizer's vaccine, AstraZeneca Oxford vaccine and others, that at least, you know, the fear was initially, will any of these new vaccines being developed within a year, will they even have 50-60% efficacy? So, you know, we're way beyond that benchmark, and that's great because, you know, that's what you need to get ahead of the pandemic, which is, you know, stopped us right. In all the countries.
ब्रिटेन और ब्राजील में देर से चरण के परीक्षणों के अनुसार ऑक्सफोर्ड व विश्वविद्यालय द्वारा विकसित वैक्सीन कोविड-19 को रोकने में 90% प्रभावी थी, जब इसे कम से कम 1 महीने के बाद पूरी खुराक के रूप में प्रशासित किया गया था। जब हमने पूनावाला से पूछा कि ये वैक्सीन आम जनता के लिए कब तक उपलब्ध होगी, तो उन्होंने कहा,
You've already got this data point with which I think they're all going to now apply for the emergency use licensure in the UK. And we've tied up, of course, with the MHRA and the Drug Controller's Office here is working with them to get an exchange of that data so that we can also apply for the same over here. Coming to your point of when will the final licensure come where, you know, it'll be available to the general public, I would say another 2 to 3 months. But before that, the good news is based on this result, based on the data we have in India, we can expect within the next 1 month, we can try to get an emergency use licensure done even in India. Of course, based on what the Drug Controller of India deems fit in terms of safety and efficacy for the people.
अब सवाल ये उठता है कि जब कोरोना वायरस का टीका भारत में आएगा और इमरजेंसी यूज के साथ ही साथ आम जनता के लिए भी उपलब्ध होगा, तो इसका आपकी जेब पर क्या असर होगा? यही सवाल पूछा हमने पूनावाला से। उन्होंने बताया कि वे प्राइवेट सेक्टर में इसकी एमआरपी 1000 रुपए रखने वाले हैं, वहीं सरकार को ये 250 रुपए में दी जाएगी।
So as we've said, you know, we're putting an MRP of 1000 rupees. In the private market, we'll sell it at 500 to 600 rupees, giving another couple of 100 rupees to the distributors and others to be able to make their margins so that they can really give the product to everybody. But to the government of India, they will be buying it at 250 rupees or less, which is roughly $3 a dose, because of the volumes that they'll be buying it at. And, you know, that's what we want to contribute to our country, you know, for 90% of our volumes, because most of that 90% is what's going to go to the government of India and maybe 10% to the private market at the higher price. So that's how we're doing it, so that, you know, even the government can manage its huge budgets that are required, you know, for the population that we have. And of course, as you know, it's a two-dose vaccine. So we've tried our best at Serum to give the absolute lowest price, at least during the pandemic period, to the government of India.
And is that price 250 rupees per dose, or is it collectively?
Per dose.
It's right. Per dose. So 500 rupees.
Everything I've said is per dose.
Everything you've said is per dose. And that 10% that you said, which might be available outside what you supply the government, would that be available from day one, or would that only be available after doctors, medical staff, frontline workers, they are dealt with?
Correct. So as I said, that'll tie in with the permissions in February, March, which will probably come for a full and final licensure. So, you know, till March, I don't think the general public would be able to get it very easily. They would have to go to the government points and areas where it's being distributed. And if they're eligible, then they'll get it from the government. And if not, then they'll just have to wait till March, because that's the priority in which not only do we want to vaccinate our most vulnerable, but also in terms of the regulatory pathway, that's how much time it will take.
इन सभी बातों के बाद ये जानना भी जरूरी है कि इसका किस पर कैसा प्रभाव होगा। हमने पूनावाला से पूछा कि क्या ये बुजुर्गों के लिए सुरक्षित रहेगी। ऐसे ही और सवालों के जवाब में पूनावाला ने कहा,
You know, anyone from the age of 18 upwards, so there have been different age groups, of course, but I think it goes all the way up to 90, so it's safe, you know, to even go up to that age group.
What about
it's
children?
Only that below 18 is something which will be tested, and, you know, we'll have to go very carefully on that, because traditionally for all vaccines and new drugs, you first prove safety, long-term safety, even in adults, before going into children, which is the right way to go about anything. But the good news, of course, is that we all know that it's not so bad for the younger population, and therefore, you know, it might not so be so bad for them to wait another few months.
इसके बाद सबसे जरूरी सवाल रहा कि बच्चों को ये टीका दिया जा सकेगा या नहीं, और अगर बच्चों को ये नहीं दिया जाएगा तो उनके लिए टीका कैसे और कब उपलब्ध होगा। इस सवाल के जवाब में पूनावाला ने कहा,
I think you know, both Oxford and AstraZeneca and other vaccine developers for that matter will have to do subsequent studies in the below 18 age group, because that's, you know, the usual way, normal way that everybody goes about proving the efficacy and safety in adults first. So I would say probably end of next year is when we could probably look at, you know, giving it to children or below the age of 18.
तो ये थे COVID-19 वैक्सीन पर अब तक के अपडेट्स NDTV सेहत वेहत के साथ। मैं हूँ अनीता शर्मा। ऐसी ही सेहत से जुड़ी और अपडेट्स के लिए हमारे चैनल को लाइक और सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें।